My name is Councillor Anissa Leach and I'm the chair of the committee. My role this evening is to ensure that the committee runs smoothly, having regard to procedure, behaviour and ethics. To explain who the rest of the people on the tables here tonight are, to my immediate right is the council solicitor, who will give advice to the committee on any procedural or legal matters that might arise. To my left are the council's planning officers, highway engineer and environmental health officer, who will present the application this evening and give any technical advice to the committee which may be sought. The rest of the people who you see down both sides of the tables are the elected members who will consider the applications this evening and make their decisions. Before each application is considered, there will be a short presentation by the planning officers. In the event that an applicant has received a qualifying petition signed by 25 signatures or more, one representative of the petition will be invited to address the committee in support of the petition for up to 5 minutes. If a petitioner addresses the committee, then the applicant or their agent will be invited to make representations to the committee in support of their application, again for up to 5 minutes. However, if a petitioner has not addressed the committee, then the applicant or their agent will not be invited to make any representations. A ward councillor can also address the committee in relation to the application. However, once the ward councillor has returned to the public gallery, they may not return to take part in any further debate. The application will then be open to debate and discussion by members of the planning committee, who will then make a decision on the application. We're going to take the order as it is today. We do sometimes rearrange the order based on the number of people that are here, but we're not going to do that this evening. If a site visit is requested and approved by the committee, then that matter will not be discussed this evening and will be discussed at a subsequent meeting following the committee visiting the site. Okay, committee, could I just have approval for the minutes on pages 1 to 10, please?
And that's fine, approved, Chair Chairman.
Are there any declarations of interest?
Yes, Chairman, item 6, just the declaration was around a host owner with urban Cheshire.
Are there any requests for site visits? Joe?
Agenda items 5 and 7, please, Chair.
That takes care of those of the agenda.
Yes, I'm afraid it takes most of the time for agenda to say. Item 6, which is Pasture Road, there's been a lot of controversy surrounding this particular application. I think it would certainly benefit from democratic of that.
Okay, I think that goes for the other two items as well. We do have a lot of objections to that, so I think it's only fair that we do the site visits for all three. Can we speak,
Greg?
Okay. Yeah, okay, then we go on to, if anybody is here for agenda item 5, which is the amenity open space site, New Ferry Road, the land of Pasture Road, Morton, or the land at the corner of Meols Street. If they're here for that application and you would like to leave, then you're more than welcome to do so. Or, you know, if you'd like to stay, then you're more than welcome to stay as well.
Okay, yeah, okay.
Okay.
Are you? Yeah.
All right, thank you. Okay, Martin, could you have a presentation for agenda item 4, please?
Thank you. detached dwellings. The site is vacant with the exception of a greenhouse which will be demolished as part of these proposals. The site is located within the primary residential area. The redevelopment of this site for housing is therefore acceptable, subject to the criteria set out in policy HS4 for new housing development. The street scene within the immediate vicinity of the site and the wider area is mixed, with a differing house type and styles of the area. There are examples of bungalows and two-storey dwellings. The majority of house types along the Ridgeway are, however, two-storey and semi-detached, although differing in character by way of design and materials used in construction. Immediately south of the site is number 10, the Ridgeway, so that's this property here. And this is a door bungalow. So the principal elevation of number 10 faces this way, onto the Ridgeway. There's a dormer along this roof line, and there's another dormer along this roof line. But just for members to note, all the windows along this elevation are obscurely closed and are not comfortable rooms. Immediately northeast of the site is this site here. And you can see on here that there are two, there's an outline of two properties shown on there. That was a site that was approved in 2014, which was the garden area of number 9. And effectively what this development seeks to do is replicate those house types. So it hands the development. So what has been approved on this site will also take place on this site but handed. In terms of this one then, this is plot number 1. If we just go to the elevation, the roof has been hipped here so that it lessens the impact on the adjoining property at number 10. And all windows in the elevation that face that property, again, are obscurely glazed and don't serve habitable rooms, and that's secured by condition on permission if members were resolved to approve it. The front elevation follows that. I'll just go back to the plan. So the front elevation of the properties has been set back slightly from number 10. Again, that's been done to minimise impact to number 10. It also follows the building line to the recently approved site next door. And at the rear, with the four little squares, that's all single storey. The two-storey element is this line here, and again on this property here. And again, the two-storey element has been pushed back from the rear elevation of number 10, so it doesn't impact on the principal windows on the rear elevation of that property. Two parking spaces are provided with each of the dwellings, so the off-street parking is in accordance with our supervisory planning document on parking, and good-sized gardens that follow the general pattern of layout in the area. And that essentially is what the application is for. There isn't a petition, a problem petition.
Thank you, Matthew. I would just like to point out to members that on page 13 of all the 1-8 items, it does say that there are 6 objections. That is typing out. There are 21 objections to this. Would anybody like to make any comments on this? No? Do we have a mover? Denise, thank you. Second that? No, thank you. All those in favour of approval to fix the conditions listed? Okay, so that's Karen's, thank you. Okay, so if you go to agenda item 8, pages 37 to 58, please. We're being asked to note these items that have been agreed under delegated powers between 6th of February and 9th of March. Are we happy to note those? Are there any comments we've got up to these?
Yeah, thank you, Chair. Page 39 on the very top one, there's no one mentioned then. And also, Chair, I think on page 49, the second one down, they're saying it's plenty of ward. I don't actually believe that that's in my ward. Park Vale Avenue, CH 43. I'm not really sure if that's in my ward.
Yes, it is a planning board.
Pardon?
It is a planning board. The, if I can explain that the ward's drawn out from a mapping system, and a mapping system is based on the electoral ward boundaries. So it may be just on the boundary of the operative Marston, but it will be the right ward.
I don't think it's a matter
of
sure.
After.
We'll check that out.
Very, very well as a team. So can I give you my personal
thanks for all this?